What's up, LNS fam? Manuel here, and welcome to another video of Lifestyles and Sneakers. Today, guys, we're gonna have a closer look on these sneakers. These are the Jordan Zoom 92. Let's go! Okay guys, so we're here to have a closer look on these sneakers. These are again the Jordan Zoom 92. So this sneakers is actually one of the latest basketball sneakers of Jordan brand. And in my opinion, this is one of the best Jordan basketball sneakers that they ever released outside of the number Jordans. So the inspiration of these sneakers is the 90s, hence the name Jordan Zoom 92. So according to the website of Nike, from the description on the sneakers, this was really inspired by three sneakers. The first sneakers that they mentioned was the Air Max 180, and then the second sneakers that they mentioned is the Air Force 5. And the third sneakers that they got the inspiration is the Jordan 7s. Now, while I was doing my research, I saw a sneakers that Charles Barkley wore during the Dream Team or 1992 Olympics, and that is the sneakers. So these sneakers are called the Air Force 180. So basically it's a hybrid between the Air Max and the Air Force. Now if you see that and you look at this, they have a lot of similarities, and that sneakers was released also in 1992. And then during that time, during the Olympics, Michael Jordan wore the Jordan 7. And it has this logo at the back or on the heel, so which is the number 9. Number 9 is the number of Michael Jordan when he was part of the Dream Team. So now we're done with the history, so let's have a look closer and check out the details and the materials that they use for the sneakers. So the upper is made out of different material. On the toe area, or at least almost half of the upper, is made out of Nubuck material. Nubuck material is the same material that you will see on the earlier Jordan models, like the Jordan 4s breads, that the materials that they use for the Jordan 4 breads, the Jordan 5 metallic, that is the material that they use. And mostly, most of the sneakers from the 90s are made out of Nubuck material. Now, what you will see on this area is a plastic see-through mesh, which is kinda, which extends up to over here. Now, towards the middle part of the sneakers, you will see this sort of like a net material. And then underneath, there is a plastic material or a synthetic material. Now, towards the back over here, towards the ankle collar, you will see a fused overlay. And then it continues with the net material on the top of the heel. So on the back, as you can see, there is a heel counter which is made out of sort of like a patent synthetic leather, and then it has stripes all over. Now on the top of the heel counter, as you can see, you have this triangular or inverted triangle which has the number 9, which is the same thing that you will see on the Jordan 7s. And then on top of that, you have a pull tab. Now the sock liner is in light gray. And then on the tongue, you will see this is sort of like a neoprene material. It's a neoprene material with a Jumpman logo on the middle in red. Now the laces is just your typical round laces. However, the eyelets over here, as you can see, this rubber that they attach on the top of the eyelet. Now this rubber gives you a little bit of nostalgia from the 90s, because I've seen a lot of sneakers from the 90s, especially from Nike, that has this similar pattern. Now, other details of these sneakers is this swoosh, which is in 3M reflective. So I'm not sure if you could see, I used flash on this video. so that you would notice the trim reflective on this swoosh. Now, apart from this Nike swoosh, the small Nike swoosh over here is also in 3M reflective. And then on the bottom of that, you will see another Jumpman logo in red. And on the opposite side, on the lateral side, you will see Zoom Air with the Nike logo on the bottom. Now, towards the front of the sneakers, you will see this red outrigger that gives you more support when you move laterally. Now, let's move on to the midsole of the sneakers. On the Nike website, they didn't mention what type of foam they use for the sneakers, but I would assume that this is Cochlon. So the midsole is sculpted, as you can see. There's a lot of design on the midsole, and it's actually two-tone. So some parts are gray, light gray, and the other most parts are in white. And at the back, you will see this Air Tex. Now let's move on to the outsole of the sneakers. Towards the forefoot area, this is plain rubber material. However, from here up to the end of the heel, they use a semi-translucent rubber. And then on the middle part, you have this Nike logo. And then on the heel, you have the Jumpman logo. Now, going back to the forefoot area, you have this Tex Zoom, because this is where you have the Zoom unit. So you have two Zoom units, two pods, over here and over here. So it's like similar to the LeBron 17s. It has two pods of Zoom unit, which gives you more stability. Now, the traction pattern that you will see on the outsole is, of course, herringbone pattern, which is common for all basketball sneakers, especially during the 90s. The insole is just your typical black insole with the red Jumpman logo. So guys, now we're done with the details of the sneakers. Now let me show you how it looks on feet. Let's go. For me, it's definitely really, really nice. I like the 90s vibe of the sneakers, and the good thing is that it is really, really light. Now I'm holding it, it actually feels like it is the lightest basketball Jordan sneakers that I've ever carried, because this is definitely really, really light. So none of the number Jordan is lighter than this sneakers. I'm not sure if they created other Jordan sneakers that are lighter than this, but definitely I can guarantee amongst all the basketball sneakers that Jordan brand ever released, this is definitely one of the lightest. I also like that it really looks good while wearing shorts or wearing jogger pants, because you can also use this for lifestyle. I'm not sure if it's gonna be too warm inside, because I don't see a lot of breathability on these sneakers. However, if you're just gonna use this for a couple of hours, then I think this should be fine, because like what I said, it is not your typical basketball sneakers that are heavy. These are definitely really, really light. So currently, guys, this sneakers is already available at the Nike website. So if you go to the Nike website, you can check out Jordan Zoom 92, and it has four colorways. So currently, these are the four colorways that they have. But amongst all these four colorways, I think this one is slowly running out. I think the biggest size that they only have right now is 9.5. So all the bigger sizes are already out of stock. However, for the other colorways, you can still get up to size 13. The fit of these sneakers is true to size, and the price of these sneakers here in the Philippines is at 7,795 pesos. And in the US or internationally, the price is at $150 US. By the way, last August 29, they also released a union version of these sneakers in Guava Ice colorway. So anyway, guys, that's about it. This is again the Jordan Zoom 92. Let me know on the comment section down below if you like this pair or which colorway you like the most. Anyway, guys, that's about it. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you do, please press the thumbs up button down below. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please press the subscribe button and click the notification bell. Follow us on all our social media accounts. Until next time.